What to do when different folate markers, MCV, figlu, red blood cell folate, serum folate, etc., don't line up.
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Julio Gaviria says, what is your opinion on folate injections? I don't seem to be absorbing oral folate. It always shows a gap on my NutrEval. Thanks. I meant folic acid injections. If you don't absorb folate, then you may need folate injections, but I'm not sure what you mean as a gap on your NutrEval. If you have high figlu on the NutrEval, which is formiminoglutamic acid, which rises when there is insufficient tetrahydrofolate THF, unmethylated folate, to metabolize figlu. And in that case, I would be thinking about maybe you have a B12 deficiency that is leading to the trapping of folate as the methylfolate form, so that THF isn't regenerated for that reaction. So I would absolutely never use figlu as the only marker of folate. I would look at serum folate and red blood cell folate always as the first markers of folate. So in this case, I would look at your serum folate and your red blood cell folate. And if your serum folate looks good, in particularly the serum folate, then you probably want to look at methyl trapping issues. I would also get a complete blood count, look at the MCV. The MCV is high, that's going to be indicating a deficiency of what we could call partially methylated folate. That's not a real scientific term, but things like methylene folate that are in between tetrahydrofolate and methyl tetrahydrofolate are used for DNA synthesis and affect the MCV. And folinic acid is the ideal supplement to deal with those. So, figlu is a reflection of THF. High MCV is a reflection of, in supplement terms, we could say folinic acid, or the intermediate forms of folate where the methyl group is partially constructed in a several-step process. And serum folate is a reflection of methyl folate. Red blood cell folate is generally a reflection of total folate status, but it also can be impacted by things that impact the transport of folate into a cell. So before I would get folate injections, I would be looking at all those markers to see whether there's a coherent story between all of them that are agreeing that your folate status is low despite supplements versus a divergent story between them that is telling you that one form of folate is the one that's missing rather than total folate. So I hope that answers your question, Julio. Thank you. This episode was part of a Q&A from members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this,
and I will see you in the next episode.